moving for the last track.
We're not that we're better than that. We want to move in there. You're going to handle it. When you say when out, what we've got, you're not trying to relight.
What?
I just didn't expect you to say.
What?
You need to be listening to it, shut up. He says his dog went out on firework night and you lost him. And he's saying, where did you lose him? And he says his dog went out. He says, why was he on fire?
Listen, because normally he was very, very placid, and on this particular night he was just going haywire, he was panicking all sorts. There was a fireworks display not far away, and he panicked and he dashed out, and we went out to try and find him, couldn't find him, and then obviously someone nabbed him.
Why someone nabbed him?
Well, we can only assume that because we never found him.
Do you put reward up?
Yeah, we did.
How much offer?
Well, let's say.
Why?
Okay, let's say £100.
You didn't want to say how much you'd buy.
Well, I did.
£100 up.
Yeah.
It's not a lot, is it?
See?
No, but it's not, is it? If you lose your dog, £100.
That was all I could afford at the time.
Okay, all right. What dog was it?
It was a staff.
Uh-huh. Okay. What was his name?
Ripper.
Ripper? Jeez, no one's going to take that dog.
It was proper.
Was he? Was he in that country? Well, no one's taking that dog. Anyway, how long
ago was
that?
2 years ago.
Okay. Anyway, we'll hopefully get there soon. We started on a strange old snow, wouldn't we? Lost object, right, Ed Sparks?
Started talking about me.
Yeah.
Started talking about you, ended up talking about me.
Yeah, but of course it's not all about me.
Right? Your show.
Yes, of course it's my name above the door. And you're lucky to be on it, but other than that. Let's talk about, player power, Jack.
Yeah.
Let's talk about Daniel. So here's the thing, right? This is why we're doing this tonight. Because I was asking Darren earlier on why there haven't been that many deals. There haven't been that many deals yet. There's been a few. And I'm not just talking about this country, I'm talking about around Europe. You know, there's so many players been into so many clubs. But there aren't biggies yet, right? And one of course, the biggest, that if it does go through, would be Wilfried Zaha. And I think the problem, personally, looking at this contract, is that Palace value him a lot higher than not just Arsenal, but any club in the world. Right? Because if they're saying he's worth £80 million plus, and it's Arsenal can't afford him, maybe another club would come in. But I'm guessing that all clubs around the world think that he's too much for someone like Wilfried Zaha. So here's the thing. What does Wilfried Zaha do? Right, is that a club? Yeah. But he wants to be playing with Europe's best. He wants to try and compete. Not just the major competition. Play with one of the biggest, the top six. Okay. If he signed a 5-year deal, 3-year deal, or whatever with Palace, and now a big club wants to come in, effectively, he's being kidnapped by the club, held to ransom, and not being allowed to leave. Now, he's in the peak of his physical career, isn't he? He's 26 years old, I think. Right? What's he meant to do? Now, I mentioned at the top of the chart that there's a release clause in all contracts on the continent. We wouldn't have this debate. His agent would have agreed the release clause just before he signed that new deal. Just say they would have agreed £75 million. If Arsenal want to buy him, they're told it's a release clause, there's no huffing and puffing, they either meet it or they don't, and then we move on. So I think that's one way around it. But Wilfried Zaha, if he's in the prime of his career and he wants to leave and his current club won't let him, what can he do? He may never get another chance to play for an Arsenal or Manchester United for that matter, or even Liverpool, or, you know, Chelsea, when that band's over, they might go for more, Man City, etc, etc. He may never get another chance. He'll never be 26 again, right? He might not be as valuable now to one of the big six as he will be in, say, two or three years' time. So what should he do? I mean, it's unfair, isn't it?
Not really. It's when you consider that he signed a new long-term contract last summer, worth over £130,000 a week. So I always think, and this isn't specific to Zaha himself, but when players are happy to take the security of a long-term deal and the enhanced wages that deal comes with, then it's unfair to say that clubs are putting them in a difficult position or keeping them against their will. Say Arsenal hadn't come in this summer, he would still be enjoying the luxury of a long-term contract on big money. When he did an interview, and he did, colleagues at the Daily Mail did a wonderful interview, the guy called Adrian Kajumba did a cracking interview with him.
Come on. Well, give Lexi the key. So you should be at the door, opening the door then. Stinks in here.
About what? Of what?
That. It's fucking honking. It's fucking honking. It should never be left like that. It should have been fucking emptied when it was full. Fucking stinking.
From now on, because there's no lid on it.